In today's video, we're going over some of the greatest car designs of the great Haracio Pagani. Pagani has become one of the biggest names in car design, working first at Lamborghini and then going on to create his own company.
Number 8.
Pagani started out working in the body shop and the composite materials department of Lamborghini, where he began working with carbon fiber. After a stint of that, they decided it was time for him to design an actual car, and it was just in time for a 25th anniversary vehicle. The special edition Lamborghini Countach was his first big-name project. The 25th anniversary Countach was originally going to be limited to 400 models, but became the best-selling Countach, selling 667 cars. The suspension was redesigned, and with upgraded tires, it was more stable and safer than previous models. Air intakes were redesigned to improve aerodynamics while continuing to keep the engine cool. With a top speed of 183 miles per hour and a 0 to 60 time of 4.7 seconds, it's faster than its other models.
Number 7.
Debuting in 1999 at the Geneva Motor Show, Pagani's first vehicle was the Zonda C12. During the design phase of the Zonda, he ran into the same problem with his F3 race car. He had no engine. He was introduced to the lead engineer over at Mercedes-Benz, which led to the Zonda C12 being fitted with a 6.0-liter V12 engine producing 554 horsepower. With his love for carbon fiber, you can bet that there was a ton of it used during construction. Only 5 of the original Zonda C12s were made, while one was used in a crash test, and another was a demonstration and show car.
Number 6.
Only 1 year after unveiling his first car, Pagani was back at it again at the 2000 Geneva Motor Show with the brand new Zonda S. Pagani was determined to show that his company was not just a one-trick pony. The new model sported multiple changes to the body style. The Zonda S had new lights and exhaust, as well as an elongated nose and flaps at the rear of the car for improved aerodynamics and turning. It sported a 7.0-liter engine that boasted 542 horsepower. Only 15 of the 7.0-liter Zonda S models were made. Pagani went on to make a Zonda S7.3, which had a larger 7.3-liter engine. Only 3 of the Zonda S7.3 models were made, but there was also a Roadster version that had a run of 40 cars.
Number 5.
In 2005, Pagani was back at the Geneva Motor Show with his brand new Zonda F, named after a Formula One driver and personal friend of Horacio, Juan Manuel Fangio. While this model shared a lot in common with other Zonda models made, most everything was re-engineered. Enhanced intake manifolds, a revised ECU, and upgraded exhaust are just a few of the upgrades. It also came with an extra headlight, a revised front end, and a brand new rear spoiler, all of which helped make the vehicle even more aerodynamic than previous models. The original Zonda F was limited to 25 cars. They went on to make a Roadster version of the Zonda F as well, which was also limited to a run of 25 models.
Number 4.
In 2009, Pagani was ready to bring us another insanely powerful vehicle. The Honda Cinque was designed to be the most extreme road-legal Zonda, and there was only a plan to make five of them. The Cinque had a brand new 6-speed sequential gearbox. The bodywork was redone with new side skirts, a rear diffuser, as well as a roof-mounted air intake. The changes made the car extremely aerodynamic. That, coupled with the power of the engine, made it the fastest Zonda created at the time. They went on to make a roadster version that was also limited to five models.
Number 3.
In 2017, at the Pebble Beach Concours d'Elegance, Pagani Automobili surprised everyone by unveiling the brand new and last rendition of the Zonda. Only three of these vehicles were ever made, and was created as a 60th birthday present to Haracio Pagani himself. It might have upset a few Cinque fans when it claimed the title of most powerful road-legal Zonda ever made, but getting your hands on one might prove tough. Only three were made, and one was retained for Horacio's personal collection.
Number 2.
After an incredibly successful run with the Zonda models, Pagani decided to bring out something brand new. Enter the Pagani Huayra, named after Huayra Tata, the god of wind. It was incredibly well received, even being named the Hypercar of the Year for 2012 by Top Gear magazine. The Huayra was a complete shock to the 2011 Geneva Motor Show with its sleek body style, gull-wing doors, and outrageous performance. Powered by a twin-turbocharged 6.0-liter V12 engine, which produces an insane 720 horsepower, only 100 units of the Huayra were produced.
Number 1.
The latest vehicle from Pagani is the incredible Huayra BC, named after a personal friend of Horacio as well as the first Pagani customer, Benny Caola. The Huayra BC was entirely track-focused and had an improved version of the original Huayra's engine. Not only was the engine upgraded, but the weight of the car was reduced using a new material called carbon triax, which is supposedly 50% lighter and 20% stronger than carbon fiber alone. Only 20 units were made, but of course, there is a BC Roadster version with around 100 units being made. So there we have it, 8 amazing designs from Horacio Pagani that shook up the automotive world. Let us know which one was your favorite from this list, and don't forget to like and subscribe to stay up to date on all our latest videos.
Hey guys, this is Cassie. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Tell us in the comments below what you found to be the most interesting and why. Also, if you haven't done so yet, make sure to hit the bell notification next to the subscribe button to stay up to date with all of our latest videos. Thank you for watching. I'll see you guys next time.